percents. Percents can be considered either a fraction or decimal. Because when you have a percentage, if I wanted to make this into a fraction, I take the percentage and I slap it over 100. Whatever the percentage is, it automatically goes over 100. And if I was wanting the fractional format, I'd then reduce. Well, this reduces down to 1/5. If I wanted my percentage as its decimal, and that's what we typically do, it's always 2 decimal places to the left. So 20% in its decimal form is 0.20. Always 2 to the left, and the reason is because you're dividing by 100. Now, we have more than one way when we start getting some very simple word problems. I can attack this in more than one way. First thing I'm going to do, though, is change my percentage into its decimal format. So it goes back 2 places, so it becomes that. Okay? Now, I can do this verbally, because whenever I see the word of, I know it means multiplication. Whenever I see the word is, it's an equals. So 0.30 times 120 is what? Well, what is my unknown, my variable? So I have something I can work with. 0.30 times 120 tells me 36. Now remember, I said I could attack this more than one way. I also have, what is a known? Is my PBR, where P is my partial, B is the base, and R is the rate. The rate is the percentage. The B is what I am taking the percentage of, and the P is the partial. So I was looking at this problem. There's my R. This is my B, and this is my P. If I can identify and plug it into this, it automatically tells me how I'm going to do the math, because what I'm looking for is what I cover. So that tells me base times rate. If I was looking for the base, and I have the partial and the rate, when we look at that, it's one over the other. So I'm going to take the base and divide it by my percentage. More than one way. I'm going to proceed verbally. Okay? What percent of 64 is 16? Again, is equal, of is multiplication, numbers drop. My what is what I'm looking for. So I'm going to call it n. So looking at that, if I'm going to solve by n, I'm going to divide both sides by 64. So n, or I should actually, I guess I really should call it r, because it's my percentage. So let's change that to an r. Well, 16 divided by 64 gives me 0.25. Now remember, percentage, it's actually a decimal. If I'm taking a percentage and moving it into its decimal format, I move it two places to the left. Right now, I'm in the percentage. I mean, my percentage is in decimal format. I want to see the percentage. I move it 2 decimal places to the right. So 1, 2 gives me 25%. Again, if I was using my PBR ball, I'm looking for the percent. That's my rate. So right there, it tells me my partial number over my base number. Again, that would be the 16 over 64 by using the circle. Okay, is my equals, of is multiplication, 60 drops, I'm looking for a percent, so that's my rate. This one and this problem is the same. I divide both sides by 60. So 18 divided by 60 gives me, if you're using a calculator, you're going to see 0.30 or 30%. Last one, again, of is multiplication, is my equals, 56 drops, my watt, I don't know what that is, 0.80, move it into its decimal format, so I'm going to divide both sides, 0.8. Now, if I was using my lovely dandy circle, I have a rate. I'm missing my base. I have the more smaller number. So that means I'm looking for the base. I cover it up, and again, it tells you the partial whole number divided by the percentage. That's this step. All right? Hopefully this has been helpful. This has been quick arithmetic review. If you need help, again, refresher on these, there are worksheets. Good luck.